Kanye West has once again kicked up controversy on Twitter with a string of bizarre tweets in which he calls the 13th Amendment slavery in disguise. Fresh off his appearance on Saturday Night Live, the rapper wrote midday Sunday, "The 13th Amendment is slavery in disguise, meaning it never ended. We are the solution that heals, sick." Minutes later he clarified the statement, tweeting, "Not abolish but let's amend the 13th Amendment. We apply everyone's opinions to our platform, sick." The tweets have left fans scratching their heads as they attempt to comprehend what exactly West is saying about the constitutional amendment, which outlawed slavery back in 1865. Technically, abolishing that amendment would allow states to enslave people again. A couple hours earlier, the artist had posted a selfie on Instagram and Twitter wearing the same Make America Great Again hat that was met with boos during his SNL performance the night before. In the caption he wrote, "This represents good and America becoming whole again. We will no longer outsource to other countries. We build factories here in America and create jobs. We will provide jobs for all who are free from prisons as we abolish the 13th Amendment. Message sent with love, sick." Many fans replied to West's tweets with direct excerpts from the 13th Amendment, asking him to explain his musings more directly. The amendment reads, "Neither slavery nor involuntary servitude, except as a punishment for crime whereof the party shall have been duly convicted, shall exist within the United States or any place subject to their jurisdiction." One user at King Yun wrote, saying, "Abolish the amendment that also help, sick, abolish slavery without being specific on what you mean by abolishing it, is him purposely being indirect for drama." Another follower at Alicia Fruits wrote, "There's 100 different ways he could have said it without sounding like an uneducated fool and stirring up unnecessary controversy, but that's all he's got." Arguably the most prominent theory posed was that West's critique of the 13th Amendment is centered on a specific clause in the writing which says people who have been convicted of a crime can still be enslaved. One Twitter user behind this theory, at LBS4L, wrote, "He's obviously referring to the as a punishment for crime part. There is a reason why the US has the most prisoners total and per capita. It's because prison labor is akin to modern-day slavery. He has talked about this in his music before, sick." Such an explanation is supported by the fact that during his SNL performance West wore a sweatshirt with the words "Free Hoover" written across the front. The sweatshirt reportedly refers to jailed Chicago street gang leader Larry Hoover. Hoover founded the Chicago street gang the Gangster Disciples. He is currently serving 6 life sentences in Florence, Colorado. The sweatshirt is available for sale at $90 on Kanye's online store. This is hardly the first time West has shared rather eccentric opinions about slavery. The rapper sparked outrage in May of this year when he called slavery a choice during an interview with TMZ. "When you hear about slavery for 400 years, for 400 years? That sounds like a choice," he said. "You were there for 400 years, and it's all of y'all. It's like we're mentally imprisoned." It wasn't until months later that West finally apologized for the outburst during a radio appearance in late August. West told WGCI he never approached or addressed the slavery comment fully because it's not something for me to overly intellectualize. He then apologized for how his tone and how his actions, including wearing the MAGA hat on several occasions, have affected his fans. "I'm sorry for the 1-2 of the MAGA hat into the slavery comment. And I'm sorry for people who felt let down by that moment," he said. Fans praised what appeared to be a heartfelt apology, but were in for another letdown when West unveiled his redesigned version of the red cap bearing Trump's 2016 campaign earlier this week. He told Fader that he had added positive energy to the hat by flattening the brim and changing its shape slightly. West donned the MAGA hat again during last night's SNL performance, after which he delivered a sermon about his approval of Donald Trump running in 2020 and how things can progress in America. "So many times I talk to a white person about this and they say, 'How could you like Trump? He's racist,'" he said. "Well, if I was concerned about racism, I would have moved out of America a long time ago." The speech was not well received by the audience, who reacted with loud boos or on social media. One of the sharpest criticisms came from actor Chris Evans, who tweeted, "There's nothing more maddening than debating someone who doesn't know history, doesn't read books, and frames their myopia as virtue." The level of unapologetic conjecture I've encountered lately isn't just frustrating, it's retrogressive, unprecedented, and absolutely terrifying. However, Trump himself appeared to appreciate Kanye's words during the show, that took aim at the president's Supreme Court nominee Brett Kavanaugh. Like many, I don't watch Saturday Night Live, even though I past hosted it. No longer funny, no talent or charm, Trump tweeted on Sunday. It is just a political ad for the Dems. Word is that Kanye West, who put on a MAGA hat after the show, despite being told no, was great. He's leading the charge. An hour later, Trump randomly declared his confidence in winning the black vote despite the fact he only claimed 8% of the black vote in 2016. So if African American unemployment is now at the lowest number in history, median income the highest, and you then at all of the other things I have done, how do Democrats, who have done nothing for African Americans but talk, win the black vote? And it will only get better, he tweeted on Sunday. Trump then took aim at the FBI investigation into Christine Blasey Ford's sexual assault allegations against Brett Kavanaugh, which he only launched after it was demanded by Senator Jeff Flake on Friday. Wow. Just starting to hear the Democrats, who are only thinking obstruct and delay, are starting to put out the word that the time and scope of FBI looking into Judge Kavanaugh and witnesses is not enough, tweeted Trump, who has fought back against claims the White House has severely limited the investigation's scope.